The African journey really started when I returned home from London in 2004 to build a Pan-African equity research product, which was something that hadn't really been done before. Along the road, I was fortunate enough to meet and recruit my current partners in Kura, Craig Banderson and Rainer Ort. Our skills and knowledge got noticed, and in 2008, we were approached to launch an Africa fund, which we did in 2009. I'm a qualified chartered accountant, and Craig and Rainer are both qualified CFAs. Each of us are specialists in various sectors across the listed space in Africa. Rainer covers financial services, Craig consumer and agriculture, and myself, telco and materials. We've been working together for over 10 years, and together we've almost 40 years experience in African financial markets. I think for me personally, it gives me the opportunity to focus 100% on portfolio management, whereas obviously in a smaller firm, I had executive and administrative duties. The other really good benefit for us is that it gives us size, critical mass. You know, there are a number of investors that just won't look at you if your firm is, you know, under $100 million. I think in the marketplace, you know, brokers and a lot of other service providers just take you a lot more seriously as a bigger firm. So yeah, we're very excited about it. I think we can easily do that. To answer your question simply, we are actually equity holders, Craig, Rainer and myself, in the new vehicle. So yeah, we're definitely aligned. I do think it's sustainable. What we've seen in the past, you know, 2.5 years, it has been incredibly tough, but I think it's been good medicine politically and economically for a number of these countries. If you take Nigeria, for example, I think, you know, the falling oil price was a blessing in disguise. It's really forced the country to improve politically, minimize corruption and leakage, and really have, you know, I think the best economic policies possible. If you look across the rest of the continent, we've seen, you know, similar actions in Egypt. They've floated their currency, which was definitely the right thing to do. In Kenya, we've just seen a very successful set of elections. So yeah, politically and, you know, from a macroeconomic point of view, I do think the growth is sustainable. And we're seeing it on the ground, you know, in the various sectors in Africa. The consumer remains robust, and that's what we like to see. It's difficult to, you know, position the portfolio, but we are diversified. We're diversified across the regions. The portfolios, you know, have investment restrictions and maximum sizes to geographies. But I think more importantly and positively going forward, I think we over a number of the Forex controls, we over a number of the devaluations. I think the, you know, trade weighted dollar has peaked, and we're now seeing, you know, a number of African countries actually strengthening against the dollar, which, you know, we think is very positive and certainly exciting going forward. Certainly we've seen the, you know, the brokerage, the sell side research improve. We have seen liquidity improve, although, now, obviously, that's been quite lumpy, and, you know, the improvement has certainly not been on a straight line. We've seen company reporting improve massively. A number of companies are now doing very detailed quarterly reports. In the past, you were lucky if you could pick up a hard copy of the financial or the annual report, you know, in the company's head offices. We also think ESG, you know, environmental and social reporting, and corporate governance across the companies in Africa has improved dramatically, and that's a very positive development. I think there are a number of interesting questions. I mean, I've alluded to improving politics and macroeconomic policy. I think sort of bringing it down to a micro kind of sector level, if you think of telecommunication, mobile money and data has been very, very exciting. Safaricom is now the largest mobile money provider in the world. So not just Africa, the world. Across the other geographies, we've seen the leading telecom companies investing heavily in the infrastructure that's going to allow those companies in those countries to leapfrog the old sort of fixed line telephony and really maximize from data. In terms of infrastructure, obviously we're seeing massive infrastructure build out. So for the most part, cement consumption and development remains very robust. The consumer, your standard consumer goods. I think the consumer is very robust. That's certainly one thing we've seen, throughout the last couple of years. Probably our most interesting sector is financial services. Financial service penetration in Africa is very, very low. In terms of bank account penetration, it can be low as 10% in Egypt, still only the mid-30s in Kenya. So we see financial services as a really, really exciting sector and some very interesting trends there as well.